be voiced out during the interview. Okay. I'll just ask you a question. They'll edit it and voice me out.
Just speak loud.
Ready?
Whenever you're ready.
Okay. Ready. Yeah. All right, just tell us your name and your position at Caverna.
Chase Goff, and I'm the new principal here at Caverna High School.
And what school did you come from?
I originally came from Warren Central. I've been, when I was there, I started my teaching career there, and then I also, in that time, I served in a few different roles. I was the athletic director, worked in curriculum and intervention, things like that.
Coming from Warren Central to Caverna, as far as sports relations, how do you think you can transist from 6A to a Class A?
Well, I think the good thing for me is that, I think Caverna has a great tradition, and that's one of the things that would attract me to any school. And that's, I'm used to that at Warren Central. I'm used to a school that's deep in tradition, and Caverna's no different. And so I think a lot of that is, me seeing the difference in numbers. But, as far as the competitiveness level, the history, the tradition, all those things, that's one of the reasons I wanted to come is the roots that are here.
And with Caverna being a Class A school, I know our first three or four games we play a couple of 3A schools and then 2A, and then we'll open up with our Class A, our district schedule. What are some of the goals that you have for our football team this year?
I think we want to compete. That's my big thing. We talked to a group of kids today, and I told them I want them to walk around with the swagger that they know that they're just as good as anybody else, that they come out here, they compete, they give it their all. And I got no doubt just the kids that we have and the ability that they have that I feel like we can compete with about any team. And so, I want them to compete. I want them to get better. I think the sign of good teams is that from the beginning of the season to the end of the season, they get better. And so, I think if we come out, compete, give it our all, and we're getting better week in and week out, we'll be all right.
And what's your prediction for the game tonight?
I predict a Colonel victory, always.
All right. Thank you.
I like them kicks, player. Where'd you get them at?
Big Mace.
Shh. I got all kind of them.
Ready whenever you are.
Ready? All right, just tell us who you are and your position here at school.
Cornelius Faulkner. I'm the Caverna Independent School Superintendent.
All right, Mr. Faulkner, you have a lot of tradition here at the school that goes back probably close to 16, 17 years, maybe extend further than that. We have came a long way since you started. And now that you are, kind of in charge as being the superintendent, what are some things that you would like to see happen here at Caverna with our athletics?
One, I think you heard Mr. Goff mention before, just to build on the tradition that's here. The one thing that really hinders us is our numbers in whatever sport. But we have enough tradition, and we spoke to students today about going and getting it. Just, don't think that because your numbers are low or whatever that you can't compete with anyone around, because in the last 10 years we've sent a lot of kids to play college sports, so just as many as anybody around us. So for me, that's the one thing, to know they have another chance to play at the next level and or have teams that are very competitive.
And adding on to what you said, a lot of times kids at Caverna are overlooked because of our being a Class A school, and we don't have the resources to get our kids out there as some of the other schools does. What are some things that the school can do, the coaches can do, and the community can do to kind of get on board to get these kids out there?
One, just support. Just be here and show up for our games and win or lose, come out and support these kids, because win or lose, we're still putting some kids in college. I really feel like, we have an opportunity at this point to, with our Little League program, football, baseball, basketball, all the other sports, getting the community involved and letting them know their child can have a real chance if they want it, because we're small. That's the one thing about being small that's great, is that you have a chance. You're not just a small fish in a big pond. You're actually a big fish in a small pond, and you have opportunity to do whatever you work at. I said this today. Don't just play the sport and compete at the sport on a simple level. Compete to be as good as you can. Don't be good for Barron County and Southridge, Kentucky. Be good for the state of Kentucky. That's one thing you hear me preach all the time to any kid that we have here.
And what's your prediction for the game tonight?
Always go Big C. I expect a win. Not a win, they gonna know we've been there.
All right, thank you.
Yes.
Whenever you're ready.
What's happening? All right, we'll start off by you just introducing yourself and kind of give us a background of where you, what school you was at previously.
My name's Brian Pretty. I'm the athletic director here at Caverna High School. I'm beginning my 24th year in both teaching, coaching, and first 17 years I taught and coached at Moss Middle School in Bowling Green, Kentucky. Coached at Orange Central football for a bunch of years. Was part of two state semifinal teams there. For the last 6 years I taught at Southmore Middle School, was the athletic director there. Helped with the high school football team, got us a state championship ring last year at South Warren. And this is my first year at Caverna, and I'm super excited to be here.
Okay. Coming from South Warren to Caverna has to be a culture shock per se. Caverna has always been rich in tradition as far as putting out athletes and being competitive every year. Our numbers sometimes hinder us from being competitive on the next level. What are some things that you would like to do as athletic director to bring this program back to where it used to be?
I think it all starts, you know, everybody's involved in making that happen, but I think once you get a continuity with coaches, and you can keep your coaches here to build a program, and when players see that they can get used to a coach over their whole 3 or 4 year period, your numbers will grow. I think a lot of the reason your numbers will possibly stay low is when you have a new coach come in, there's that unsure of what that is, and that doesn't make people nearly as excited to play. So when we can get people here that want to coach and want to be a part of Caverna and watch our numbers grow, I think you'll see. The biggest problem with numbers is we have the same athletes anybody else has, but depth will get you in any game, especially like football and some of those things. So you can compete with people for 2 and 3 quarters, and when you have kids that play both ways and everything, they're just going to get wore out. So we're going to look to try in all of our sports to try to get people that want to coach at Caverna and stay.
With this being your first year and first season at Caverna, and this is the first game for our new coach, Sean Thacker, how do you think that Coach Thacker will do here at Caverna?
I think he's going to do awesome. He's walked in from day one, and he just does a little bit of everything. I mean, I'm in the hall, and he's working in the computer lab. Everywhere you go, he's doing something. So Coach Thacker didn't move from Eastern Kentucky to coach football. Coach Thacker came here to be part of Caverna. And that right there, I can tell you, will bring success. The kids take to him. You know, he's got a fiery attitude, but you can tell he wants the best. And I think you'll see that out here. I think you'll see a difference in Caverna football tonight.
And I see that tonight the faculty is tailgating. I know we did that once or twice a season, maybe a couple of years ago. But there seems to be a little more excitement about football this year. What do you think is causing the excitement for our season to start?
Well, I think Coach Thacker, like I said, he's come in and he's doing things right off the bat that, you know, he had meet the colonels. He's getting in, you know, when you have your coach get in the dunking booth and do those things, that'll bring a lot of excitement to it. And like I said, they're just out here working hard. The kids are taking to it. And I think, you'll see a difference in Caverna football.
Well, the forecast called for 75% chance of rain tonight. The forecast has changed, and I think the conditions are definitely favorable for Caverna. With our speed, what is your prediction for the game tonight?
We're low in numbers, but you know, Edmondson County may have 10 more players than us, so we're not using that as an excuse. I think hopefully, like you said, if we come out and use our athleticism to our advantage and take care of the football, I mean, this game's about blocking and tackling. I mean, you can draw it up any way you want, but ever since my first year of coaching, if you block and you tackle in football, you're going to win a lot of football games. So these kids will be ready to go, and I predict, I think you'll see Caverna wins tonight.
All right, thank you, Coach.
Thank you. Josh was doing good though. He just kept coming.
So it's like the police are here. No arrest.
Extra point is good. Flag on the play. Thank you. Personal foul, roughing the kicker. Penalty will be assessed on the kickoff. Take over first and 10 from their own 10-yard line. Flag on the play. False start. Penalty is declined. Result of the play is a safety. Thank you. touchdown Wildcats. Extra point attempt is good. With 10:55 to go in the first quarter, Wildcats with 16, Caverna with 0. First and 10 from their own 35. No gain on the play. A gain of 4 yards. Five-yard gain on the play brings up fourth down.
What?
number two on the carry, good enough for first down. One yard gain on the play brings up second down. Three-yard loss in the play, and it brings up third down. Touchdown, number 22, Wildcat. Extra point is good. Attention all Colonel fans, be sure to buy an athletic season pass that will admit you into most home sporting events throughout the school year. Adult passes are $50 and student passes are $25 and can be purchased from our athletic director, Brian Pretty. I think I got it. sides on the kicking team. No gain on the play. Incomplete, brings up third down. And 10 yards. About the 53rd yard line. Paul's pass incomplete. Intended for Spears. Timeout on the field. Come on. right, intended for Howard. Brings up third down. Equipment infraction on Guevara, 5-yard penalty. First charge timeout. Wildcats take over first and 10 from their own 33-yard line. Game good for a Wildcat, first and 10.
Come
Town Wildcats. Extra point kick is good. Just a reminder, Colonel fans, if you would like to purchase a pass that will get you into all home games, most home games, adult passes are $50 and student passes are $25, and they can be bought from Coach Brian Pretty.
Let's go!
Eagles take over first and 10 from their own 12-yard line. Flag on the play. Result of the play is a first down. Incomplete to number 15, John Paul. Result is a second down. Paul's pass incomplete, intended for Howell, resulting in a third and 10. Quarterback sack brings up fourth down. Punt down in the Wildcat 39-yard line.
Okay, now let's get him down and get him his drink. And now I've got, like, I should give him a Dr. Pepper.
You can't.
We gotta go get Taylor a drink. Yes, we do. We gotta go. When I need a drink.
Nope.
Even that guy.
Sorry.
attack.
Pass incomplete brings up third down. Game good for a Wildcat first down at the 50-yard line. Incomplete brings up second down for the Wildcats. Game good for a Wildcat first down. Gain good for another first down on the Wildcats. At the end of the first quarter, Wildcats take the lead with 30 and Caverna 0.
Oh.
Incomplete pass brings up second down for the Wildcats.
You can go back. Okay.
Touchdown, Wildcats. Extra point is good. To the owner of the burgundy-colored Chevrolet parked by the baseball field, your lights have been left on. Charles Bass complete. No gain on the play. Incomplete to number 15, John Hall. Incomplete brings up fourth down. Timeout, Cabrera. Their second charge timeout. Corona High School would like to take a moment to recognize our corporate sponsors, Houchins, Lindsey Wilson College, Joe Publishing, South Central Bank, Advanced Signs, Western Kentucky University, Davis Auto Parts, Coca-Cola, South Central RTC, Goodman Chevy, and Citizens First Bank. John Powell. Wildcats take over first and 10 on the Cabrera's 49-yard line. Gain good for a Wildcat first down. Nice. Doing good for another Wildcat first down. Flag on the play. Holding against Edmondson County. 10-yard penalty. Replay, first down. Broken by number 45, Dylan Sturgeon. Quarterback sack for the Crows brings up third down. Go, go, go. Edmondson County. First charge timeout.
From Travis, whatever his name is, he said that he has to go to the last game. And that there's no good, there's not going to be anything after that. No, like,
just a reminder, athletic season passes are on sale for $50 for adults and $25 for students. If you would like to buy one, see our athletic director, Brian Pretty. Is up and it is good.
What do I do?
Get, Intercepted by the Wildcats.
Rebecca!
Take over first and 10 at their own 10.
Okay, come down here. Actually, no. I'll go ahead and give you some
mushrooms. I got a cat.
I'm
gonna put it online.
I know. Yeah.
As soon as I walked out of the bathroom, I saw someone from the Wildcats making a major catch.
Right on the way.
Like someone on the Wildcats.
I was straight up. That's why you get stuck.
Procedure penalty against the Wildcats.
Attack. Hey, you the one gonna go
high.
Thank you. $50 and student passes are $25 and can be purchased from our athletic director, Brian Brady.
Let's go, Cardinals!
All pass complete to number 17, Drew Rhodes.
Too far down.
Now can you?
Uh-uh.
Yeah, you can.
All pass incomplete, intended for Spears.
I like Spears.
What's Christmas? Oh, watch out. Get up, baby. Get up. Go, here, look, you got to go under. Let me see. If you're going to be out here playing, you got to be tough. You're going to do it again. Do not come around with me. Come here. Come here.
I worked with him at Curry.
Really? That's my brother. His wife needs it.
All's game good enough for a first down.
He was at church at
the Yeah, last Sunday.
Yeah. She's a senior now. She goes to last week.
You wouldn't know that.
Yeah. She was true.
Oh, yeah?
She plays softball.
He's down there. I don't know what he's doing. Them weddings, they got the real names.
Really? You do a lot,
Get on it!
No.
I don't know, baby.
Go.
We need to find them. Because there's only 5 minutes.
Paul's pass complete to number 3, Tony Spears. Brings up second down. Paul's pass intercepted, but flag on the play. Illegal blocking in the back.
Hey, little shady.
Officials, time out on the field.
Yeah.